Welcome to 2K Sports Annual Noche NBA Presentation. We're excited to bring you this celebratory fusion of basketball and Latin culture. Welcome, everyone, courtside with two ex-NBA stars, Grant Hill and Brent Berry. I'm Brian Anderson. We've got Ali LaForce on the sidelines tonight as well. Let's see some of the numbers here for DeMar DeRozan.
And he's having issues at the free throw line at the moment. In the past 10 games, his touch hasn't been the same as it was before. He'll be trying to correct that tonight.
Now let's take a look at the Kings' opening lineup. Up front, it'll be Murray and Sabonis. Fox runs point with Herter by his side, and it's Barnes in at the three spot. And for Chicago, we've got Zach LaVine, Patrick Beverley out there with Alex Caruso. Then there's Nikola Vucevic, and it's DeRozan in at the four slot. And down the stretch here, each night threatens to reshuffle the playoff seedings.
Well, I love this time of year, B.A., because you're getting up in the morning, you're jumping on the internet, you're trying to check to see, well, what happened last night? Did they lose a half game? No. Are they up 2.5? Can we still get there? This is what it's all about.
And here's Herter. To the middle. And he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
And such a strong part of what Sabonis brings to the game. Quality passing.
Pass to DeRozan. Vucevic, a screen on Murray. Here's DeRozan. A shot, no good. So Sacramento will take it the other way. Their last encounter in Sacramento.
They were able to pull out a win last time because their bench came up big. So important to have depth on your roster.
Probably looking for more of the same here. As we know, a deep bench, so crucial to any team's success.
LaVine with it. He picked up 36 points in their last win against the Rockets in Houston. Pass to DeRozan. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play opportunity.
Keegan Murray.
And a different kind of score. DeRozan attempted 741 mid-range jumpers last year, almost 300 more than anyone else.
At the line for one.
Grant DeRozan, high volume from the mid-range and extremely accurate.
You know, B.A., he consistently makes about half those shots. And defensively, you know that's his favorite area. But his ball handling and vertical negate anything you throw at him.
Now here's Murray. His offense has been solid, scoring around 11.5 points a game. Sabonis finds Murray. Clock at 4. And the foul on Alex Caruso. That's his first foul of the game.
Kind of a ticky-tack foul there, but you have to be aware that's how the refs are going to blow the whistle tonight.
First quarter of play with about 1.5 minutes gone by. Picked by Sabonis. Barnes with it, guarded by Vucevic. And the shot goes down.
Barnes can be hard to contain sometimes around the rim. He can create just enough space to be effective.
Now here's LaVine, a top-tier scorer, averaging a little under 25 points a contest. Pass to Vucevic. Back to LaVine. Clock at 6. Ooh, excellent D there from Barnes.
I don't think the defense does enough out there to bother him. I think that one's all on him. Just a flat-out miss.
Here's Herter. It's good. And the assist goes to Murray. Herter's got 5 points.
Nice ball movement. good job by Murray to recognize the situation and create the wide open look.
That one's good for two.
Easy look when the defender isn't fighting over the screen.
Yeah, the coach over there just asking for one simple thing, and that's some effort got burned on that one.
Now here's Fox. 35 points for him last game against Milwaukee. To the inside, puts up the 8-footer, and he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws. Well, Grant, the shocker of the 2022 trade deadline, Domantas Sabonis going to the Kings.
Big time surprise. Tyrese Haliburton going the other way to Indy. Now, I like that deal for both sides. Sacramento adding an all-star big, the Kings needing some size, Sabonis adds that.
Free throw drops for Sabonis, and seems hard to believe, but it's been almost 40 years since the Kings moved to Sacramento.
And you know, maybe they haven't hung any banners, but they've had some special players and some great seasons in that time, and they mean a lot to that community.
And Sabonis drops them both.
Well, Sabonis is an unselfish player. You can see it in the actions out there on the floor. He's trying to get the best out of both himself and his teammates.
Beverly, a screen on Barnes. Jacks up a three. Hauled in by the Kings. Outside Murray. Pass to Herter. Here's Sabonis. 23 points for him last game against Milwaukee.
And he also controlled the boards. He just seemed to be in the right position every time the ball came off the rim.
And guess what, guys? I mean, one of the ways De'Aaron Fox improved his skills growing up was playing 2K, learning the NBA game on 2K. I love it.
De'Aaron Fox taking two shots.
Shooting two.
Down the first one, and De'Aaron playing 2K growing up, his dad encouraged him to observe. Take note.
Good advice. I mean, De'Aaron learned a lot about things like ball screens, pick and roll from playing video games, stuff like that. I mean, Fox used 2K as a way to study the game of basketball.
And both free throws good for Fox. Back on draft night 2017, the Bulls trading away their star, Jimmy Butler.
And what a haul they got from Minnesota. Zach LaVine, the headliner, and he's turned out to be a franchise player. It's tough to win one of those type of deals, but Chicago got a stud.
Now here's Murray. Up top, Sabonis. Out to Fox. Puts up a three. The shot is good on the assist by Sabonis.
For three.
Fox has got 5 points.
Boy, I like their energy coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Well, if there were four or five boxes to check in terms of the game plan tonight, they might have checked six. I mean, they're doing everything out there.
Now here's DeRozan. He picked up 27 points in their last win against the Rockets in Houston.
Yeah, but there's always this point you got to look at, where did he also impact the game? It was on the rebounding end of the floor. A tremendous performance there.
They're getting torched on the perimeter. Four of the last five buckets have been threes.
For Chicago, they've gone 2-for-7, a sluggish start. Chicago calls timeout. This game following their win against the Rockets.
Sometimes it's difficult to get good looks on the road, but they ran the offense brilliantly.
Well, it was probably a good feeling in that last game that the mid-range worked, the long-range worked, the inside game worked.
And over the last month, these are the teams that have been getting it done on offense. Number one, Sacramento.
This team has really found a great offensive rhythm lately, running smart plays, sharing the ball, and racking up points.
Pass to LaVine. To end the run. Oh, and the jam by LaVine.
That's the sauce right there. I mean, every night, LaVine approaches the rim like it's a dunk contest.
And that replay courtesy of the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. For Sacramento, they've gone 6-of-7 and looking good. Outside Herter. Back to Fox. Sabonis with a screen on Beverly. Here's Fox. And another basket for Sacramento.
So far, they're owning both ends of the floor. We'll see if they can keep this going.
Like tonight, that all the hustle plays have meant so much to this team. Now just sustain some of that energy and keep comfortable.
Now here's Fox. He has seven. Pass to Murray. Here's Sabonis. It's good. And the assist goes to Murray.
An outstanding first quarter from the field.
The Bulls have gone only 3 for 9 from the floor. Beverly outside. On the wing, DeRozan. Over Murray. That one's wide left.
Things are going south right now. This is not the type of shooting that his teammates expect from him.
Fox against Beverly. Sabonis. Count that bucket. Sabonis has got his second basket on the night.
Fox does a great job of sizing up the defense and then finding a hole. So good at getting in there.
Levine passes to DeRozan. Beverly outside. Counted from distance.
And not where he earns his money, that three-point shot. But he's a good shooter from that range if he's got space.
Sacramento has gone 4 for 4 so far from three-point land. Impressive. Fox outside. Nice D from Vucevic.
Man, I thought he was making that in so close. That's some aggressive defense.
He can't get it to go. Good D by Murray. And so here's Sacramento. 16-point lead. Defeated by Milwaukee in their last game. They'll try to put that one behind them.
There obviously was a breakdown at the defensive end. They gave away too many clean looks.
Yeah, sometimes you can play good on-ball defense, but it's the help defense that makes you elite. And on that night, nobody rotating and not a lot of help.
Levine gets the bucket.
Man, he's got that touch working tonight, shooting the ball very well to start this one.
Pass to Murray. Herter with it. Down low. Here's Sabonis. Drops in the layup for two. Sabonis has got 8 points.
They have no answer defensively inside.
Chicago has gone 2 for 3 from outside the arc. Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over.
And with Kevin Herter, I just love the plug-in ability of him as a player. He just can play some with the ball, a little bit off the ball, a good cutter, lots of complementary skill there.
Some changes for Chicago. Andre Drummond has checked in for Vucevic. Williams comes in for DeMar DeRozan. And it's Dosunmu in for Beverly. And the Kings will go for a different look here. Lyles, he's checked in for Murray. Davis comes in for Barnes. Monk, he's checked in for Herter. And Mitchell subbed in for De'Aaron Fox. Pass to Dosunmu. To the right side. Now Drummond. We saw him with 11 points in his last game. Drummond with the screen. Caruso outside. 5 to shoot. Now Drummond. Played it in with a nice touch off the window.
That's where you got to get Andre the ball. The closer he is, the more effective he becomes.
And here's Davis. Looking at the numbers, he's putting up 7 points a game. Inside, here's Sabonis, and Sabonis slams it in.
Now, there are only a few players in the league who can hit a teammate like that in stride. Beautiful assist.
The Bulls have got 6 of 14 in so far. Williams, a screen on Monk. Pass to Dosunmu. Back to Caruso. The three is up. Again, it's Chicago with a three.
This defense is getting spaced out. 3 of the last 5 buckets have come from way beyond the arc.
Mitchell with the ball. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Here's Lyles. The shot is good on the assist by Sabonis.
3 points.
Sabonis has got his third assist of the night. Now here's Levine. Drummond, the screen on Davis. Here's Levine for three. Monk grabs the miss.
And this is exactly who you want taking that shot. He just missed it.
Well, Drummond's going to move you out of the way through contact at 300-plus pounds. That is a big man to try to keep out of the lane.
Now here's Monk. They look to him to score consistently, averaging around 13.5 a game. Davis misses. Chicago's gone 3 for 5 from deep so far in this matchup. Here's Dosunmu. Checking his numbers, he's put up a little over 9 points a game. Rejected by Sabonis.
Sabonis has to use good timing in order to block shots. That time he did.
Oh, it's blocked by Levine. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Levine. White, he's checked in for Caruso. Sabonis, the pass to Monk. Now Mitchell. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Pass to Davis. Shot clock at 6. Drains the triple.
They've really built this lead on the back of their perimeter game.
Well, a lot of importance placed on outside shooting. And tonight you can see why after that kind of quarter exploding from the perimeter.
White, the pass to Drummond. Goes up and lays it in nice and easy. Drummond's got his third bucket of the night.
Showing off some mobility there. When Drummond rolls like this, he's hard to stop in pick and rolls.
Monk for three. That one doesn't drop. Now Chicago takes it the other way.
One thing the Kings got when they hired Mike Brown is a coach who's been through and seen it all with his NBA coaching experience.
Pass to Williams. Outside White. Over Monk. White. Good.
Hey, they're just getting pushed around inside.
1:04 left in the opening quarter. When it comes to Mike Brown, he's been an assistant or a head coach for 6 different teams now, Brent.
That's a lot of different kitchens to be in, BA. And as an assistant, he's worked for great coaches, Greg Popovich, Steve Kerr, Rick Carlisle. It's a great group of coaches to draw upon and then add his own styles in and what he wants to do with this Kings team moving forward.
All right, guys, some stats here. The scoring breakdown for Sacramento.
Well, they found a groove, and it's from distance. So knocking them down from the three-point land never hurts.
Now, getting to the inside is really important, but it's how close you can get to the basket. It feels like these guys are all around the rim in their attack tonight.
And he drops the first. The Bulls making a switch here. Jones has checked in. The Kings also with a sub. Holmes has checked in. That one goes in. 2 from the line that time.
Oh, guys, the city of Chicago is used to the highest standard. The shadow of those Michael Jordan teams still looms large.
Here's Dosunmu. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Good.
I love how they've attacked the boards here in the first quarter.
Drummond's gone 4 for 4 shooting tonight. On the wing, Mitchell. He's averaging about 6 points per game. Davis, that's good. 3.
Already 6 of their points coming off second chances. Pretty impressive.
4 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And he's going for the oop here. Throw it down on the lob.
The pass, the catch, the slam. What a clean play.
And absolutely jaw-dropping. Mitchell's shot is good.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
Well, I know they don't have mobile devices out there for texting, so they might as well talk to one another.
It's been all about Domantas Sabonis for the Kings. He had solid production this quarter with scoring and rebounding. We'll be right back. 43.
Ladies and gentlemen, your full
youth. just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And guys, we've seen the Kings really take control here.
Well, so far, they've got things rolling along nicely at the offensive end.
Yeah, couldn't ask for a better one right now. Just a complete rhythm by all the guys who got some minutes. Wonderful start.
Chicago has gone 3 of 6 from deep so far. On the court for the Kings, second quarter underway. Fox runs point with Herter by his side. Barnes is out there with Murray. And it's Holmes in at the 5 down low. And the basket by DeRozan.
Now that's an assertive offensive talent. DeRozan is able to use his size to his advantage.
Sacramento has gotten 21 points so far from three-point land. They're 7 of 10. Three-pointer, Fox, and the Kings with another three.
Lackluster defense, showing no desire to chase shooters off that line.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Allie LaForce.
Thanks, Brian. Well, De'Aaron Fox is a competitor. He said, I want to win. I know there's more that I can do. Just trying to create a spark, some type of energy. You can talk about what you did in high school and college, but you have to take it to a totally different level if you want to be one of those guys in the league. Brian?
Allie, thank you. Well, Sacramento is shooting the ball incredibly well tonight. 73% from the floor. He takes it in. And it's Chicago with a board.
Well, they shouldn't be giving that shot to anyone, but they certainly shouldn't be giving it to him. That's a big break for the defense.
Knocks down the long J. DeRozan's got 10 points in the game.
Yeah, I mean, they put so much focus on Vucevic, it leaves a wide open man.
Vucevic against Holmes. Now here's Herter, tightly guarded. Good work defensively by White. The Bulls have got 2 of 3 shots to go in the second. Pass to Vucevic. Back to White. Vucevic, a screen on Herter. White drives in over Herter. White can't hit. For Sacramento, they've gone just 1 of 3 to begin the second quarter. Herter against DeRozan. And here's Holmes. Picked by Holmes. Fox, the pass to Holmes. And that one goes in as he's fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts the free throw.
During the summer of 2021, Rashawn Holmes signed a 4-year contract worth about $45 million. That's a pretty big prize for a guy coming out of a JUCO.
Zach LaVine, he's checked in for Chicago. Caruso comes in for White.
One shot.
Sean Holmes, a great example of persevering.
NBA, if you've heard any of his story, which I know you have because you do the work, Holmes had a growth spurt late in high school. He went from 6'2 to 6'9. No major offers, goes to a JUCO, transfers to a D1 school. Not everyone is a 5-star recruit, but guys like Rashawn Holmes, they take their time, and the time is well worth it.
Herter, the basket's good, off the assist from Fox.
For three.
Fox has got 4 assists in the game.
Shot preparation is fantastic as Herter's able to get his feet set that time.
Beverly outside. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own. Hey, Beverly's got 6 points.
These teams are finding the range, showing a lot of confidence.
It seems like they're going to find out who can make the deepest threes. Right now, it's a shootout.
Now here's Fox. He's got 10. Again, the Kings score.
Tough matchup here, and Fox has it going right now. The lefty getting some room and making it happen.
Pass to Vucevic. Vucevic, a screen on Herter. LaVine passes to Vucevic. Stolen by Holmes. Herter against Caruso. To the wing on the left. LaVine against Barnes. For three. Another three for Sacramento.
You got to have a player you can trust if you're going to call a number that involves a pick and roll. And Harrison Barnes making a good decision there.
Levine passes to DeRozan. Beverly with it. The three is up. It's hauled in by Herter.
Man, you get so caught up in the bravado of someone scoring on you and you wanting to even the score. Unfortunately, he couldn't answer back.
And the foul on Patrick Beverly. That's foul number two for him.
This is one where the second foul is probably going to cost you some minutes in this game.
Domantas Sabonis, he's checked in for Holmes. Murray against DeRozan. Pass to Fox. Now Herter. Six to shoot. Shoots over Caruso. Herter can't hit. The Bulls have gone 3-for-7 here in the second quarter. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for two. Well, Grant, one thing Levine has done since entering the league, he's taken his strength training very seriously.
No question. I mean, he can play a much more physical brand of ball now. We even see him post up with his back to the basket, converting through contact. It's just part of his overall evolution.
That free throw, good from Levine. And when you're trying to slow down a top scorer, often the game plan is to get physical. Grant, you would know better than anybody. What's it like in the trenches here?
Well, B.A., it's interesting. I mean, it can wear on you. It's a mental challenge. When you're in the trenches trying to slow down a great offensive player, it really becomes a battle of wills. You have to stay focused. You have to be disciplined. And most importantly, you just cannot take a playoff and allow a great player to get going.
Now here's Fox. 12 points for him. Vucevic with a steal. DeRozan against Murray. Oh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take two free throws now. That'll belong to Domantas Sabonis.
I mean, just so difficult to keep DeRozan out of the lane. He draws a lot of fouls in there in the paint.
DeRozan, two shots.
First free throw is good. DeRozan hits them both.
And give them credit for making a more concerted effort to get to the line this quarter.
Fox outside. Murray passes to Herter. Sabonis with a screen on Caruso. Herter finds Sabonis. Hey, in six attempts, he's made five. Talk about efficiency.
Not much else the D can do. Sometimes Sabonis can score no matter what you're throwing at him.
Chicago has gone 2-of-4 from the perimeter in the second so far. Timeout called here. Chicago decides to talk it over. All right, a chance now to take a look at the steals over the last few months for Alex Caruso.
I get the feeling he hasn't been paying as much attention defensively as he should be. His steal numbers have dipped in the past few months. He needs to get back some of that intensity on defense.
Pass to DeRozan. Here's Vucevic, shot clock at 5. Offline with a 3.
And they're plus 5 on the boards after that rebound.
Here's Murray. The basket's good off the assist from Fox.
The assist.
Fox has got assist number 5 here tonight.
Yeah, just a solid play by Murray. He knows where to get his shots.
Now here's Beverly. He had 16 in the win against Houston.
And he also controlled the boards. He just seemed to be in the right position every time the ball came off the rim.
Much more efficient this quarter, feeling more and more confident.
Herter passes to Murray. Fox for 3. And the Kings with another 3.
D has been just completely helpless and turned around. He's so dangerous when he's in this kind of rhythm.
Here's DeRozan. That one no good. Great D that time from Murray. And here's Herter, coming off a 28-point game against Milwaukee. Pass to Sabonis. It's Barnes on the wing. He's covered by LaVine. The basket counts, and one. He'll go to the line, a chance at a three-point play.
Pretty focused play right there from Harrison Barnes, showing he has what it takes to convert sometimes those challenging buckets like that one there.
Chicago making some changes. Drummond's checked in for Vucevic. Williams comes in for DeRozan. And it's Dosunmu in for Beverly. Davis, he's checked in for the Kings. Monk comes in for Herter. You know, back in 2010, Harrison Barnes was the top recruit in the country out of high school, Grant.
Yeah, and interestingly, Barnes decided to play two seasons at North Carolina. Unheard of these days for someone with Harrison's pedigree.
Now here's Caruso. Right now averaging 5.5 a game.
Two teammates connecting right there. Slick feed.
Monk with it. To the paint. Here's Sabonis. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair. It's going to go on Andre Drummond.
Sabonis is such a fantastic prospect. A guy you think is going to play 10 or 12 years in this league. And a good job there getting contact and getting to the line.
Shooting two.
First one falls for him.
Yeah, just knocking down every free throw. I mean, I love to see this kind of efficiency.
Some changes for Sacramento. Lyles comes in for Barnes, and Mitchell subbed in for Fox. He's perfect from the line this time. Chicago has gone 6 for 12 from deep so far in this game. Pass to Dosunmu. Outside LaVine. Fires from deep. And again, it's the Bulls from deep.
And this team leans on LaVine on offense. They encourage him to take these quick shots.
On the wing, Mitchell. Back to Monk. Mitchell with the ball. Drummond grabs the miss. Pass to LaVine. Williams, a screen on Davis. Here's LaVine for three. Davis with a rebound. On the wing, Mitchell. Out to the right wing. Here's Lyles. And once again, off the mark by Sacramento. The Bulls have gotten 6 shots to fall out of 13 attempts here in the second. Pass to Williams. To the inside. The fader. That one a tad offline, but it drops in for him. Drummond's got 10 points in the game.
Well, the mid-range, not really his go-to, but a soft touch on that one.
Now Monk. On the wing, Davis. Misses the three.
He's not the guy that you want to give a wide open look from three-point range. They're lucky that that one doesn't cost them.
Well, they're on the right path now, but still in a pretty big hole.
Well, the run simply has given them a chance. Great work on both ends. They've got to now ratchet up a notch.
So it's Sacramento now. The Bulls making their last shot. Sabonis with a screen on Caruso. Here's Monk. And they're going to count that bucket, and they'll send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
I like their mindset. Staring at a deficit, they're pounding it inside for high-quality shots.
Some changes for Chicago. Jones comes in for LaVine, and it's White in for Caruso. Lenz checked in for the Kings. Chicago's gone 50% from the perimeter in the second, shooting 4 of 8. They set a pick. Now here's Jones. Pass to Drummond. Blocked!
Well, putting the wingspan to great use, Len throws that one away.
I'll tell you what, they've rebounded the ball tremendously well.
Davis, the pass to Mitchell. Down low.
2 minutes.
Drummond grabs the miss. Drummond's got his fourth rebound in this one. Pass to White. Outside Jones. That one falls, coming off a Drummond feed. Jones has got 5.
The defense is nowhere to be found guarding the three-point shot.
Here's Mitchell. Outside Monk. Back to Mitchell. Outside Monk. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Over White. Rebound by the Bulls. Chicago with the ball. They're on a 13-5 run. And let's send it over to Allie LaForce.
Thanks a lot, Brian. Well, the Kings made a big trade last season to acquire all-star Domantas Sabonis. It's clear they want a break from their lead-long playoff drought, and they're hoping he can help them do it. He said, quote, "It's exciting. I want to be here. We're going to fight and get wins." Back to you.
Yeah, they're all in, Allie. Thank you.
Kobe White taking 2 shots.
That's good from White. Holmes, he's checked in for the Kings. White hits them both.
It's not luck that he's so steady at the line. It's through repetition and hard work.
Here's Monk. He's got 5. Holmes, a screen on White. Here's Monk. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot 2.
Man, the defender really went after him.
At the line for the Kings, Malik Monk, 2 shots.
Shooting 2.
And the first one at the line is good. Hits both from the stripe. There's 42 seconds left in the half. Here's Dosunmu. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Here's White. Inside. Right side. Williams. White on the wing. Just 5 to shoot. Jones sets a screen. White can't hit.
Well, that's how to protect the rim. Without fouling, force him into an awkward release and a bit of an adjustment on the layup.
Pass to Lynn. Shoots over White. Lynn is good. And the Kings lead by 19.
Well, he's a high percentage shooter that close. Lynn being aggressive right now every time he's getting the ball in the paint.
And so it's the Sacramento Kings.
Welcome, everybody. Let's get right to it. It's been nothing short of a tremendous challenge for the Chicago Bulls.
First of all, where's the intensity on D? You'd think when a team is punking you like this, you at least try to put a stop to it. But nope, they just keep giving up open looks, letting the lead get bigger and bigger and bigger.
And let's get back to our featured game, a fantastic battle between these two guys.
They've each been fantastic tonight, playing with fire, doing just about everything. Lots of pressure on these two in the second half.
I remember being the guy on the given night. Well, for me, it was all nights.
That's it for us. Thanks for tuning in. Now let's send you over to Brian Anderson with the third period. There wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. Boy, it's been one outstanding game from De'Aaron Fox.
Yeah, he plays such a smart first half, maximizing his opportunities offensively.
Yeah, I'm thinking back to the first half and wondering, did he take a low percentage shot? Everything efficient.
Nikola Vucevic is out there with DeMar DeRozan. Then it's Alex Caruso, then it's Patrick Beverley, and it's LaVine in at the three slot. So that's the five in the game for Chicago. Now here's Fox. Pass to Sabonis, shoots over Vucevic. Sabonis can't hit. Chicago shooting a nice 50% for the game. LaVine passes to Beverley. Out left to the wing. Vucevic, a screen on Herter. Here's Caruso, and you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance at a three-point play.
And he gives up some size inside, but makes a great adjustment on the finish.
Yeah, the big man not going to slow him down from getting that deuce.
At the line for Chicago, Alex Caruso, shooting one.
One shot.
The free throw drops for Caruso. The Kings shooting incredibly well, 63%, and really making their shots count. Fox finds Barnes. Sabonis with a screen on LaVine to the middle. Out to Fox. Six on the shot clock. Outside Barnes. Off target with the three. And here's Chicago. They haven't given up any points here in the second half. Minnesota will be traveling to face them after this game. It'll be the second of three straight games on their home floor. Right around a minute and a half played in the third quarter. Fox against Beverley. Launches a three, and De'Aaron Fox with the three. Fox has got 18 points in the game.
Just incredible. I mean, he's really making it rain out there, knocking them down one after another.
Kind of like he's in his living room right now. He's found a comfort zone. Once he gets that, the defense knows they're in trouble.
And that one drops for him.
And not wasting any time here, kicking their offense right back into gear. That's 3 of 4 from the field.
Outside Herter. Chicago grabs the miss.
Yeah, they're going to try to search out for somebody that's got a hot hand right now. 1 of 4 to start the half.
DeRozan outside. Pass to LaVine. Back to DeRozan. Over Murray. That one off the back iron and out. The Kings have gotten only 1 of 4 shots to fall in the second half. And De'Aaron Fox picks up the foul. That's his first foul.
Hey, that's just their first turnover. Overall, they've done a great job taking care of the ball.
A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Outside LaVine. Parked it down low that time. Got hit with the 3-second call.
All right, let's bring up the leaderboard and see which players were the most efficient from the charity stripe last month. Fourth, Harrison Barnes.
And over this stretch, his foul shooting has been exceptional. You could tell he was enjoying every single trip to the line.
Beverly against Fox. Picked by Sabonis. Can he keep it going? And once again, off the mark by Sacramento.
Yeah, starting the half here, 1-for-5, and the offense might need an ironing out. You know, guys, they say speed kills, and in this case, it kills defense. Fox just so quick with the ball.
Now here's LaVine. 12 points for him. Vucevic gets the bucket.
I mean, they've been relentless. Just keep getting shots at the rim.
Third quarter of basketball here. A little under 3.5 minutes gone by. Fox, the pass to Barnes. Now here's Murray. To the inside. Here's Sabonis. Yes, and it's Murray picking up the assist. Sabonis has got 16 points. And with that quickness, Fox is so difficult for defenses to contain, Brent.
Yeah, the one thing, B.A., that I love is when De'Aaron picks a tough angle to match up against, because guys tracking him, they're going to lose a little bit of steam. And when he gets ahead, great decisions are made.
Now Murray. He's got 5. Fox outside. From outside the arc. Herter can't hit. The Bulls have gotten 4 of 7 shots to drop in the third. Caruso, pass to DeRozan. Pass to Vucevic. 4-3, drops in the 3. Vucevic has got his 2nd bucket on the night.
I'm not sure there's a better stretch 5 than Vuc.
Oladipo, they've gotten only 2 of 7 shots to go in the third quarter. And here's Fox. 18 points for him. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up. It's going to belong to Nikola Vucevic.
So close on the finish. I mean, it could have been a 3-point opportunity.
And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Kings.
Yeah, what stood out to me was their passing. They moved the ball effortlessly and have been able to find those holes in the defense.
And it seemed like throughout this game, right after the jump ball, they've just been feeling it from distance, getting all the looks they want and continuing to take advantage of that 3-point line.
Both good from the line that time.
It's definitely a part of the game that Fox wants to work on. These haven't been easy for him in the past.
Vucevic, a screen on Fox. And LaVine with the basket on the assist from Beverly. LaVine's got 4 points this quarter.
He's trying to will this team back into it, doing all he can offensively.
Sacramento has gone only 1 of 3 from deep here in the third. Fox with the ball. 20 points for him. Down low. It's tipped. Shot's good by Sabonis. Sabonis has got 18 points in the game.
And Sabonis, no stranger to physical play.
Now here's Beverly. 6 points for him. Vucevic, a screen on Murray. Here's DeRozan. Not going to go that time. So Sacramento will take it the other way. Earlier in the game, they held a 25-point lead. Here's Fox, an important scorer for this team, averaging around 25 and a half a game. 6 to shoot. Sabonis with a screen on Caruso. There's the 3. Herter can't hit.
Teammates right now covering up for the type of off performance he's having. In terms of scoring, this has not been his best night.
Now here's DeRozan. He's got 16. Over Murray. And the basket by DeRozan. 18 points for him.
And his fantastic performance from the last game has carried over to tonight.
Yeah, and the coach pretty smart for zoning in on him and giving him opportunities to stay with that confident play.
Here's DeRozan. 18 points for him. From 18 feet away. Again, the Bulls score.
Oh, the lost art of the mid-range jumper. DeRozan dialing it in.
Fox against Beverly. Sabonis with a screen on Beverly. Fox, that's good.
He means business. Unlikely to be a comeback on his watch.
Well, he's grabbed a tee and a blanket because he's putting this one to bed.
Now here's Beverly. He has six. Here's Levine for three. It's hauled in by Herter. Sabonis outside. Pass to Fox. This one for three. The shot is good on the assist by Sabonis.
Three.
Sabonis has got four assists now tonight. Levine against Barnes. DeRozan outside. Puts it up from 15. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Sabonis has got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. And a fast break now for the Bulls. And here's Caruso outside. Connects from downtown. Caruso's got 6 points in the quarter.
Well, if you're open, Patrick Beverly is going to do his best Sacramento to get you the ball.
Timeout called. Sacramento. Though Chicago ends up going with a new group. Now that we're late into the season, here's how the East stacks up. Taking a look at Chicago. And after a subpar season, there have been some questions about the direction of this franchise.
Checking out the Bulls, this season has been a series of one frustrating night after another, on and off the court.
Well, sometimes you earn your spot in the standings, and they've done that this year. There looked to be so much promise, so much talent on this team coming into the year. It's just baffling that all of those things went south for them.
Now here's Monk. He has 7. Picked by Holmes. And it's Monk, that time on the assist by Holmes. Monk's got 9.
Good look from the big man as Holmes gets it to the other guy and not forcing his shot.
Chicago's gone 2 of 3 from outside so far in the third quarter. Now White. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. Inside. Here's Drummond. Second chance shot. And it's good on the lay-in. He's got 12.
And Drummond can sit on that weak side block or in front of the rim and just be a tough guy to move out from the lane. He'll get those offensive rebounds.
Now here's Mitchell to the paint. Here's Lynn. And he throws it down with one hand.
And you can't leave the basket unprotected. Bad things will happen to you.
Yeah, that was just way too easy.
Will not find a higher percentage opportunity than that.
Lynn's gone 2 for 3 from the field. Pass to White. Here's Drummond. Outside Jones. Drummond to screen on Holmes. Drummond with the ball. Lynn's there. Oh, sweet move. The shot by Drummond. No good. For Sacramento, they've gotten 7 of 14 attempts to fall in the half. Here's Mitchell. Here's Lynn. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line.
Shooting for Sacramento. Alex Lynn. Shooting 1.
Well, Chicago shooting an excellent rate of 56% on the third quarter. Pass to White. Outside Jones. Drummond with the screen. Here's Dosunmu. Drummond with the ball. Clock at 6.
2 minutes remaining.
That one's good. 7 for 10 now.
They're really looking to that inside game here in the second half. Getting away from taking a bunch of threes.
The Kings have gone 50% from the field in the third quarter, 8 of 16. And there's a minute 45 left in the third quarter. Monk against White. And it's Monk off the drive. No good from 11 feet. Chicago has gone 2 of 3 from outside so far in the third quarter.
The pass, the catch, the slam. What a clean play.
Man, absolutely jaw-dropping. 1:24 left in the third quarter here. Pass to Lynn. And here's Mitchell. Drummond grabs the miss. Drummond's got rebound number 7 tonight. Now Williams. 58 seconds left to play in the third. Drummond to screen on Mitchell. Drummond high post. And they get it back. Pass to Dosunmu. And again, it's Chicago with a three.
The defense takes a chance, leaves him open at the arc, and he capitalizes.
Mitchell, the pass to Davis. Here's Lynn. Nice assist and nice finish. Solid play all the way around. Lynn's got 7 now in this quarter. And it's the Bulls with the ball. A 12-point game. Here's Dosunmu. Pass to Jones. Outside, Williams. Inside. Here's Drummond. Good. 8 buckets in 12 attempts.
Yeah, he's leading the charge for them. But let's be honest, he needs more help if they're going to get out in front.
Yeah, doing anything he can right now to get his team to cut into this lead and give them a chance.
Some sick ball skills displayed right there. And he's not the guy you expect to pull that off.
And so it's De'Aaron Fox making highlights for Sacramento, helping them space the floor. 2 triples in that quarter. 3 for the game. All right, stick around. We'll be right back after this. All right, let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
Talk about painting a magnificent picture with that dime. Just a great decision and a perfect delivery.
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that you want to put on a canvas. Just beautiful basketball.
Well, there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. Taking a look at Sacramento. Up front, it'll be Murray and Sabonis. Fox runs point with Herter by his side. And it's Davis in at the 3. Sabonis. Yes. And it's Murray picking up the assist.
Assisted by
Murray's got 6 assists now in the game. Beverly outside. On the wing, DeRozan. Over Murray. It's tipped.
Yeah, great work on defense right there. Shooters have to be careful when Murray is lurking nearby.
And out of bounds. The Bulls will take it. And this is what the schedule looks like for the Sacramento Kings. On Thursday, they'll take on Ben Simmons and the Brooklyn Nets. Then on Saturday, they'll take on Kristaps Porzingis and the Washington Wizards.
And you know, for that matchup with the Celtics, that's one that could easily go either way. A few mistakes could be the difference. I expect it to be a fun one.
And they pick up 2.
This is where Levine's coordination shows up, able to make adjustments in tight.
That was another look at our Mobile One drive of the game just a moment ago.
Yeah, a double-digit deficit. They're going to have to play better. They need more of this kind of aggressive play.
Fox against Beverly. To the middle. Outside Murray. Left side Herter. Fox, that's good. Fox has got 12 points here in the second half.
And just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
Now here's Beverly. About a minute and a half through the fourth quarter now. Levine finds Vucevic. And he gets that one.
The merciless play by Vucevic down low, crashing through the contact to finish strong.
Fox outside. Sabonis with a screen on Beverly. Here's Fox. And Fox powers it home.
So shifty, Fox gets in there anytime he wants to.
The Bulls have gone 2 of 3 to open the fourth quarter. Pass to Vucevic. Three-pointer. Knocks it down from distance.
He's a producer. It's part of their plan to get him as many touches as possible.
And here's Fox. Outside Davis. Fourth quarter play. We're about 2.5 minutes through it now.
Oh, you gotta love the back and forth. Showing real confidence at the arc.
Yeah, both teams finding ways to the three-point line and trying to take advantage from distance.
Now here's Caruso. Up top, Levine. Checked by Davis. Levine passes to Beverly. Shot clock at 3. That drops. And it comes off an assist from Levine. Levine's got his 3rd assist of the night.
Beverly showing off a little bit of a teardrop. Didn't know he had that.
The Kings have gotten 4 of 5 attempts to fall so far in the fourth. Outside Davis. Chicago with a board. Vucevic has got 6 rebounds in the game. DeRozan passes to Beverly. Outside Levine. Shoots. Again, the full score.
The scoring is coming easy for him. Got to keep the ball in his hands.
A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Herter passes to Sabonis. Fox with the ball. Over Beverly. And there's Fox on the assist from Sabonis. Sabonis has got 5 assists tonight.
Clutch buckets. He's paving the way as they hit the home stretch.
Now here's Beverly on the wing. Levine. Misses from close range. The Kings have gotten 5 of their 7 shots to fall in this final quarter. Levine against Davis. Sabonis with a screen on Levine. Vucevic with a steal. Outside Levine. Caruso right side. Levine against Davis. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
And every year, Levine seems to get better and better. His work ethic and desire to be great is evident.
Zach Levine at the line for 2.
Shooting 2.
The first one falls. So the Kings making a change here. Barnes is checked in. And that's good as he hits both shots. The Kings shooting 61% for the game, knocking him down. Pass to Sabonis. Outside Herter. Sabonis with a screen on Caruso. Herter finds Sabonis. 4 on the clock. The offensive rebound. Out to Fox. Sabonis with a screen on Levine. Down low. Levine with a steal. Pass to DeRozan. Here's Vucevic. And the power!
Just an intelligent play by DeRozan. Takes full advantage of the open gap in the defense.
It's Sacramento has gone one of two from deep in this quarter. Fox, the pass to Sabonis. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up. You know, for team owners, it often seems best not to take too active a role in basketball decisions. But, Grant, you're a team owner. How do you feel about this?
Well, it's a tough situation, B.A. Many of these owners have made tremendous amounts of money building their fortunes, of course, being very hands-on with their business. But basketball is a different kind of business. Success is not always linear. And sometimes, as an owner, you're not an expert when it comes to this particular business. So it's interesting, kind of being engaged, but not being too hands-on and letting your people do their job to the best that they can.
Sabonis drops them both.
If they keep hitting free throws at this clip, it'll help them seal the deal.
The Bulls have gotten 6 of 8 shots to fall during this fourth. Pass to Levine. Caruso outside. Levine with a screen on Herter. DeRozan up top, defended by Murray. And Chicago again with a bucket.
Again, it's DeRozan. I mean, just a big, big night. It feels like DeMar's been doing this forever.
Now a timeout called by Sacramento.
Let's give Coach credit. He's trying to find a way to squeeze the most out of every possession.
Got to feel good as a coach if you make all those adjustments. Pull the right strings. That's what they love to do.
A moment to hear from Allie LaForce.
Hey, guys. I was able to listen in on the Kings head coach talk to his team during the break. So far, he's happy with their play, but he wants to prevent any kind of a letdown. He told the team, stay aggressive. Don't play not to lose. We want to push the action and try to break their spirit.
Thank you for that, Allie. Outside Herter. Sabonis with it. Fox outside. Pass to Herter. Shot clock at 6. Out to Sabonis. Stolen by Caruso. Beverly into the lane. Over Fox. Beverly's shot off.
They have a decent advantage in regards to rebounding.
Outside Herter. Vucevic against Sabonis. Now here's Herter, guarded closely. Deflected!
Can't be lazy around Patrick Beverly. He's going to get you down low with hands. That time, he blocks a shot.
He gets it in there.
And they've really relied on him down the stretch.
The Kings leading. Now here's Fox. Sabonis with a screen on Beverly. Fox with the ball. Guarded by Vucevic. He was all alone on that one. Fox has got 8 points in the quarter.
Scoring well this quarter. Picking up steam as he goes.
Barnes against Levine. To the wing, right side. 6 to shoot. From the top of the key. The shot comes out. Sacramento has gone 1 of 2 from deep in this quarter. And there's Murray. That one's good. On the assist from Fox. Fox has got 6 assists now in the game. For Chicago, they've gone 8 of 12 so far here in the fourth. Pass to Levine. DeRozan outside. Good D by Murray. For Sacramento, they've gone 7 for 11 so far in the fourth. Herter against Caruso. Here's Fox. Doesn't go that time. Great D that time from Beverly. Trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch offensively. They could really use a basket.
Levine against Fox. Levine passes to Vucevic. Four on the clock. The three from DeRozan. Gets the three to fall. DeRozan's got 25 points.
Well, that equals his three-point total from the first half. He had one before the break, and that's his first three of this half.
Now here's Herter. Sabonis with a screen on Caruso. Steps back. Here's Herter. And out of bounds, it'll be Chicago ball.
And I'm all for the crowd interacting with the players, but not so much the players interacting with the crowd. That one, errant pass.
Chicago has gone 2 of 2 from outside so far in the fourth. Vucevic, a screen on Murray. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way.
A high-effort play by DeRozan. I mean, his ability to absorb the foul and still put up the shot, magnificent.
DeMar DeRozan, two shots.
Shooting two.
And he makes a first.
And they've done well from the free throw line this half. No misses yet.
And so he makes both from the line. Sacramento has gone 1 of 2 from deep in this quarter. Outside Murray. To the inside. Vucevic with a steal. Fox against Beverly. Outside Levine. Shoots over Sabonis. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Earlier in the game, they held a 25-point lead. Back to Fox. Down low. Shot's good by Sabonis. Sabonis has got 10 points in just the second half.
Running like a well-oiled machine at Sabonis at the helm.
Here's DeRozan. And count that. 2 points and a chance for one more at the line.
Taking people to school with moves like that.
Harrison Barnes. Second personal foul. Third team foul. At the line for Chicago. DeMar DeRozan. One shot.
That's good from DeRozan. 1:50 left in the fourth quarter. Pass to Murray. Back to Fox. DeRozan with the rebound.
Yeah, my expectations were that he was not going to miss that one. He handles that kind of defense, especially on the inside.
Outside Levine. Back to DeRozan. Vucevic, a screen on Murray. DeRozan finds Vucevic.
Man, it's hard not to foul Vuce inside. Murray. He uses all of his size to go after his shots.
Fourth team foul. At the line for the Bulls, Nikola Vucevic. Taking two shots.
Shooting two.
He gets the first, and that shrinks the margin to just 4.
A quality shooter from the stripe. I mean, let's see if Vucevic can capitalize in a big spot here.
And so Vucevic nails both of them.
He's the one person that the coaching staff and the teammates love to see at the line in a tight ball game. You can pretty much bank on these.
So Sabonis with a screen on Beverly. Here's Fox. And it's Chicago with a board. Beverly outside. Pass to DeRozan. 51 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Shoots over Sabonis. And again, Chicago, no good. Here's Fox. Money!
That is a mature play from De'Aaron Fox. Not afraid to take the big one.
Now a timeout called by Chicago. They're trailing by five. There's 39 seconds left in the fourth quarter here. Davis, he's checked in for Barnes. There's 39 seconds left in the final quarter. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
Third personal foul, 15 foul. At the line for the Bulls, DeMar DeRozan. At the line for two.
Shooting two.
He drops the first one, and that shrinks the margin to just four.
And DeRozan wants the rock in his hands in close game. I mean, he embraces the opportunity to come up big for his team.
So he gets them both.
Yeah, they desperately needed those free throws, and he delivered. It's down to a one-possession game.
Sacramento calls timeout. They're ahead by three. There's 37 seconds left in the fourth quarter here. There's 37 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Now Fox. Shot from the wing. And they recover it. And an intentional foul right there. Timeout called. Sacramento. They're in front by three. We've got 22 seconds left in the game. And Sacramento has possession, and so they choose to intentionally foul.
Personal foul. 13 foul. One for the Kings. De'Aaron Fox. Two shots.
He hits the first one, and that gives him a 4-point cushion.
Now, not shying away from the moment, it's De'Aaron Fox's time with a big opportunity. Knock it down.
And so both free throws good, and it's a 5-point game.
And just like that, this game is a 2-possession affair.
Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over. They're behind by five. There's 21 seconds left in the game.
No doubt. They've got to get a quick bucket here.
It's funny, at this point in the game, the coach is asking the team to be perfect. They haven't been to this point.
There's 21 seconds left to play in the fourth quarter of this one. Vucevic, a screen on Davis. Here's Levine for three. And he sinks it. And he's brought them within 2 points now.
Now that's one to remember. What an impact on the game.
I'm wondering, is that the biggest shot of the game?
Yeah, just trying to keep this game alive. Not a bad foul right there.
One for the Kings. Two.
on the first, and that makes it a three-point lead.
And for a point like Fox, handling the ball late in games, I mean, you'll be in this situation a lot.
So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a four-point ball game.
All but over now. Those free throws help seal the deal.
DeRozan for three. He's off on that one. So a close game sees Sacramento taking this one. Just a gutsy performance on the road.
It really was. When this one was up in the air late, they showed how tough-minded they are as a team.
And that'll do it, folks. Alongside Brent Berry, Grant Hill, and Ali LaForce, this is Brian Anderson with our entire 2K crew thanking you for watching as we present our New Balance Player of the Game, De'Aaron Fox.